any more of this as Super Cologne just being decimated by the LWO. That's terrible.
Well, Scott, I wonder what kind of condition Cologne's going to be in. He's scheduled for that big tag team matchup later here this evening on WCW Saturday night. He's set for a tag match with Kidman against Eddie Guerrero and Juventud Guerrera of the LWO.
Oh, man, Cologne, what an opportunity that was for Cologne to team with the Cruiserweight Champion. Now you got to wonder, is he going to be able to go?
Well, they just turned everybody loose on him. What was it, 7-8 on one?
It's ridiculous, but that's typical Latino world order. Eddie Guerrero, Hector Garza, Dandy, La Parca, Psychosis, Juventud Guerrera, et al., they all love anything but a one-on-one fight.
Well, here is the master of the meltdown. Raff on his way to the ring to take on, well, a young man who had the WCW World Tag Team title around his waist for a short time when Rick Steiner had handpicked him as his tag team partner. We're talking about Kaos of High Voltage.
What a challenge for Raff to take on Kaos here on Saturday night.
In terms of a physical matchup, it's going to be a pretty even test for Raff, who goes 6'8", 295 pounds, the muscular Kenny Kaos. Well, obviously, in terms of height, he's giving away probably in the neighborhood of 6-7 inches to Raff, but in terms of physique and body weight, he's right in there with Raff.
Collar and elbow tie-up. Raff backs Kaos into the ropes. Oh, look at the power and the strength of these two, just two bulls in there.
Now, pretty much what we expected, power versus power in the early going.
Earlier on,
the referee try and get in between these two.
Earlier, Mike, we saw the tribute to Hollywood Hogan, a man, love him or hate him, and most fall within one of those two categories, not much gray area there. He did change this great sport that we love so much. And Hollywood Hogan has hung up the boots. No longer a professional wrestler. Has to change his business card, I guess.
Now, the man who totally revolutionized professional wrestling is now going to see if he can create a revolution in politics, running for president of the United States.
Taking the inspiration from Jesse the Body Ventura and taking it up several more notches all the way to the White House, Hollywood Hogan. He's aiming high. You give him credit for that.
You know, earlier tonight we talked about Diamond Dallas Page, all the great charity work of WCW superstars. I want to point out that this young man, Kenny Kaos, who connects with the snap suplex, quick cover on Raff in a two count, is a volunteer football coach in Kennesaw, Georgia, my hometown at Harrison High School, the eighth grade Hoyas. He took them actually to the championship game this year.
Wow.
Another great thing that the WCW athletes do for their community.
Oh! And Kaos maybe wishes the community would run in and help him here as Raff just throttles Kaos in the corner. Referee Charles Robinson warning Raff that Raff just unleashed. He suffered his first defeat at the hands of Kevin Nash, but he gave Nash all he could handle.
Well, it was quite a test for Kevin Nash. Big said he came out the victor in the end on that Nitro a couple of weeks back, but as I like to point out, we have seen that Raff has been able to bounce back from that defeat, maybe better and stronger than ever. Knife-edge chop on the floor for Kaos.
Raff sets Kaos up. Reversal by Kaos and Raff hard into the rail. Almost into the fifth row. And Kaos now drives Raff head first into that same railing. And Raff is staggered. Look at this.
Oh, back first into the ring apron. Strength versus strength as we anticipated. And Kaos is holding his own.
Kaos with an assist to Raff back into the ring. Raff waits on him. The boot into the back. Oh, and those are some stiff kicks from Raff across the back of Kaos.
Well, now that I see the way that Raff has reacted and recovered in a hurry, he may have been playing possum with Kaos out there on the floor. Kicks him up. Nice slam in the middle of the ring.
That had authority. Hooks the leg deep. Two count on Kaos. Kaos slowly getting back to his feet. Raff just stalking his man, but Kaos fires back into the gut. Another left into the stomach of Raff, and Raff with a knee.
Now Kaos fought back from the mat, but Raff just has the momentum on his side at this point. He connects with the back elbow.
And Raff just the picture of intensity, does not intend to suffer another loss in WCW. You know you are double tough and on the fast track to the top when you're all worried about one loss and wrath is consumed with avenging that loss to Kevin Nash. Shoots Kaos in, charge in, wrath, caught the boot to the face from Kaos. Kaos sets it up in the corner with a knee.
Cutting with that knee in the midsection, chance to turn the tide. Another left hand from Kaos. That one may have rocked the big man, or maybe it was just a wake-up call.
Into the corner. Oh, the corner clothesline from Kaos. And Kaos may be wasting a little too much time here.
That was a lariat with authority in the corner.
Reversal.
Back. Nice shoulder block.
And Wrath, look at that face. You don't need to hear it when you can read it in the face of the big man.
On the way to the meltdown, Kaos trying to fight him off. Going to have to lift him up to his shoulder.
Oh.
That's 265 pounds and he just melted down.
That had impact. And Wrath will win it over Kaos.
Impressive win for Wrath here on the Superstation as the body count continues. Another win for Wrath in the meltdown.
Standing by backstage, it's B-Team and Chris Jericho.